Elise Briscoe. I'm an integrative optometrist and a clinical homeopath. And today I'm going to be talking to you about ways to protect your eyes from airborne infections. When you're in a public area such as the market, a park, or any environment where you could potentially be exposed to the coronavirus, which then causes COVID-19, it's a good idea to protect your eyes. And the reason is the eyes are one of the portals to the body through which the virus can enter and then eventually reach your lungs. So on a sunny day like today, I opt for a pair of glasses. Sunglasses. They're lovely, and even though it doesn't completely seal off everything from getting into your eyes, it does provide a physical barrier, and it's substantially better than not having any glasses on at all. It also reminds you not to touch your eyes. If you're a contact lens wearer and it's not too sunny outside, you could just get a pair of clear glasses like these. And that will prevent contaminated moisture particles in the air from adhering to your contact lenses and sticking and staying inside your eyes. When a sick person coughs or talks, virus particles can spray from their mouth onto your face, and most likely you will inhale it through your mouth or nose. However, the particles can also enter through your eyes, and that's why it's important to wear sunglasses or glasses as a barrier when you go outside, the same way that we're wearing face masks. The reason that the government hasn't been opening up public areas yet is there's a lot of super infectors and people who are carrying the virus but don't know it. So that means these people are walking around and they can infect you even though they don't know that they're sick. There is also the concern about a second wave of COVID-19 happening if we open public areas too early. You can also become infected by touching something that has the virus on it. And that could be a doorknob or a table. And that's why this hand washing craze has started. In fact, during cold and flu season, I often see more patients who come to the office with a viral or bacterial conjunctivitis because they've infected themselves, either by blowing their nose or coughing, and then they rub their eyes, especially with kids. I see a lot of kids who've gotten it from touching computers at school, infected toys, and then they touch their face and their mouth. So these rules apply during cold and flu season, not just during COVID-19. The adenovirus, which causes the common cold or flu, can live on a dry surface for up to 30 days. It's unclear on how long the coronavirus, which causes COVID-19, can live on a steel or dry surface. But so far, the estimates are anywhere between 3 to 17 days. So wash your hands. Another healthy eye tip to be extra precautious during COVID-19 is to not wear your contact lenses while you sleep. I recommend to my patients the daily disposable lenses, because then you're not reusing a lens that has been potentially contaminated with droplets and viruses while you're outdoors. So before I go to bed, I just take my contact lens off and throw it away. In fact, I recommend that my patients don't wear their contact lenses when they have a cold or flu, because then you could be keeping bacteria, germs in your eyes during the day, and it's better just to throw them away. Have a wonderful day. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, you can hit me up on Instagram. My handle is @HollywoodEyes. And stay healthy through all this.